Picture this, you spend hours and hours making an edit, and after all that, they still look like this? Well, today, I'm going to show you 4 things that most beginner editors skip that could massively improve your edits. Let's get started. Mistake number 1. Many beginner editors don't use high quality clips for their edits, meaning that their edit's quality is doomed right from the start. I've seen people get clips by screen recording off YouTube, but it's much better to use the original movie or a high quality scene pack. The only problem is, these movies and scene packs often come as an MKV, a file format that you can't import into After Effects, meaning that we're going to have to convert the file, preferably with minimal quality losses. I'm going to be using Wondershare UniConverter, and if you want to follow along, I'll leave a link in the description and the pinned comment to download it. Special thanks to Wondershare for sponsoring this video. So once you have your file, open the conversion feature in Wondershare UniConverter and drag it in. You can click this button here to shorten the file. I'm going to trim out the end credits to reduce the file size. If you want, you can also crop, rotate, or mirror the file as necessary. I'm going to cut out a few pixels at the top and bottom of the film, as there are usually black pixels that can interfere with head tracking. Make sure you set the aspect ratio to crop size to reflect the crop changes, and then click save. Now we can use the AI helper tool to help us decide what video format we're going to encode to. Since I'm going to be using this file in After Effects, I want smooth playback but also a lower file size, so I'm going to choose the most compatible MP4 format. Now we can select which subtitle and audio tracks we want to keep in the final file. I'm going to keep the English audio track and remove all the subtitle tracks. Now click on the settings icon to customize the encoding settings. You can mess around with these settings if you're confident, but if you're not, just copy these settings. Now you can click save, set the export location, and click convert. Here are a few frames side by side, and as you can see, there's been no quality degradation before the encodes, and now you can use this file in After Effects. Mistake number 2 is not separating the vocals of the audio from the background music and other sounds in the scene. This makes the final edit sound much cleaner. So to do this, disable all the audio tracks except for the scene's audio and export it as a waveform audio file using these settings. Once you've done that, open up the Vocal Remover AI tool in Wondershare UniConverter and drag in the audio file that you exported. It should take around 30 seconds to process depending on how large the file is, but once that's done, you can set the file location and export the vocals. Now drag this file back into After Effects and unmute all the other audio tracks that you disabled, as well as muting the original audio track. Here is the comparison of the audio before and after.
Master has presented Dobby with clothes. Master has presented Dobby with clothes.
Mistake number 3 is not using AI to enhance your clips before you export your edit. So once you have your edit ready in After Effects, disable all the extra elements, including text, zooms, CC, or any icons or logos. Once you've done that, go to File, Export, and then click Add to Render Queue. Then click on Output Module and set the encoder to QuickTime. Go into the format options and set the video codec to Apple ProRes LT. If you want, you can also use AVI for the encoder and lossless for the format, but I prefer using QuickTime and ProRes. Click OK and then render the file. Once it's finished rendering, open up the Video Enhancement AI tool in Wondershare UniConverter and drag in the file. Depending on what type of enhancement you need to do, you can select an AI model, but I'm just going to go with the basic quality restoration model. Set the file location and then export the video. Here is what the clips look like before and after the AI enhancement. If you want to further enhance the quality of the video, you can apply a color correction. I'll leave a link to a free color correction I made in the description. But if you want a more premium, stylized CC, you can buy my silver or lapis CC at masterofdeath.store. Mistake number 4 is not compressing your video and allowing YouTube, TikTok or Instagram to compress it for you. I'm going to show you the best export workflow that you can use with After Effects and OneShare UniConverter so you avoid this quality loss. Export your final edit from After Effects using the same method I showed you during the previous tip. Once you've done that, open the compression tool in OneShare UniConverter and drag in your file. You can compress based on quality, size, or use the AI compression tool, which can just select the best settings for you. I found that using a quality of 90% works best for uploading to YouTube and 80% works best for TikTok. So once you've selected your desired quality, click Save, set the export location, and click Compress. Here is a comparison between 80%, 90% and the original file, and my eyes can barely tell the difference between them, despite the massive difference in file size. Anyway guys, that's it for today's video. Once again, thanks to OneShare for sponsoring this video. I'll leave a link to download UniConverter in the description and the pinned comment. If you want to learn how to make this fiery aura effect, click on this video and I'll see you there.